My name is Alexander Roque. I am the president and executive director of the Ali Forney Center, and my pronouns are he, him. COVID-19 has had a devastating impact on our work. The Ali Forney Center is open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Our doors do not close. As the pandemic has worn on, we are facing some devastating funding cuts. Simply put, many states are losing money in vital programs, and one of the most vital programs that we're losing funding for is our HIV education testing treatment program. It's a program that employs about 17 co-workers throughout our sites and works with our young people every day on understanding HIV, understanding risk, understanding prevention, and we are losing almost $1 million in that funding. This funding loss is extremely detrimental to our work. The CDC finds that young people ages 16 to 24 are the highest infected with HIV in our country. And that is exactly the population we serve, young people ages 16 to 24 who are largely from communities of color. The Ali Forney Center is the nation's largest and most comprehensive organization dedicated to housing and caring for homeless, lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender young people. These are young people who are kicked out of their homes because of their identity. They are rejected by their families because of intolerance, because of homophobia, because of transphobia. And our mission is to protect these homeless young people from the harms of homelessness while providing them with the tools they need to rebuild their lives. Each year, the Ali Forney Center sees over 2,000 young people who know the heartache and heartbreak of family rejection. And we keep our doors open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week to provide them with the care and the services they need to rebuild their lives. Our medical clinic, the home of our HIV programs, is really about building community, helping our young people speak about HIV, helping them to understand their risks, helping to connect them to medication and treatments to help manage HIV or prevent HIV. And what we're finding with this funding loss is that really destroys this clinic. It destroys this community for us. It is such a vital part of our work. When you think about the youth we serve, the population, we know statistically in the United States, more than half of homeless youth are propositioned for sex within 72 hours of being homeless. 87% of the young people in our care tell us that they sell their bodies to survive. This is typically in exchange for food, shelter, or money, absent our care. The loss of this clinic really breaks down those conversations and helping to connect these young people with options to be safer. When people think about homelessness, they think about the physical things that people don't have, like a home, a warm bed to sleep in, food, clothing, those kinds of things. The losses that our young people experience are far more devastating. Our young people lose the access to love, the access to families and support, and our work is so much rooted in that. On the surface, yes, we are providing food and shelter and access to clothing and things like that. But fundamentally, what we are demonstrating for our young people is that they are worthy of love. They're worthy of having a life of their choosing. They're worthy of giving love and receiving love. And they are worthy and have a place in our world. We desperately need to refund our health services program. Losing $1 million for an organization like ours has detrimental effects on our ability to connect with these young people and offer them vital tools to survival and to staying safe. We are seeking lead gifts in donations from foundations and corporations to help put together an adequate health services program for our youth. In closing, thank you so much for your time. Thank you for allowing me the opportunity to tell you about the important work that we do. Thank you for your care. Please help us amplify this message. There are so many ways you can help. Tweet about us, post about us, tell your friends about us. It is incredibly vital work. And although you may never meet the thousands of young people that come through our doors every day, I can tell you wholeheartedly that we appreciate any support you can offer us.